and welcome to episode 52 of China Tools, a series of videos where we put woodworking tools from China to the test. My name is Dennis and I am from Hooked on Wood. And my essential accessories are attached to the side of my height adjustable wall latch. One of these accessories are these hole down clamps. I showed them in episode 29 and I rated them 4.5 stars. And they are among the most used China tools in my shop. And I recently received these new design hole down clamps. And they come in different versions. And I can already say that one of them at least deserves a fixed place in my workbench site. And another product is this drill guide. And depending on the work you do, it can be a useful tool. And in the description of the product, they talk about an improved version. And it happens that they also sent me the former version a few weeks ago. So it will be interesting to see where it is improved. So these are two exciting products to discover. And in my last video, I showed you this beautiful T-ruler with my logo on it. And I understand the first 100 have already been shipped and they plan to ship 200 next week. Anyway, production is running and I hope you will receive yours soon and of course enjoy it. I want to start with the clamps because they look very promising. And when you open the box, you immediately notice these are impressive clamps. And even though the clamping mechanism is from hard plastic, the shaft is nicely finished and strong. And they are much bigger than the hold down clamps I tested in episode 29. But they are not too big to become impractical. The next difference is that the shaft of the bench dog clamp from episode 29 is structured. Although this initially scared me, I did not feel any noticeable wear in the dog holes. And of course the reason behind this is that because of the structure, it has more grip in the hole and will clamp immediately and consistently. And I think this works. It clamps well and fast and creates an impressive clamping force. And my top of the workbench consists of two layers of MDF and plywood. And because of this, it creates more clamping power than when you use only one layer. The shaft of this new bench dog clamp is smooth, but with just a hair below 20 mm thick. It fits very tight in the holes. And with a top of two layers, this sometimes causes some trouble when the hole is not drilled perfectly straight. If I hold them against my reference bench dogs, they measure 19.95 mm, where the hole down clamps measured 19.96 mm. But this tight fit is essential to letting it clamp a workpiece in place. And here we come at the biggest strength of this clamp, and which I love it so much. It is so easy to clamp. It works effortlessly, has a perfect size, and it's just comfortable to work with. The aluminum clamp from episode 29 gets some wear over time, which makes clamping a little bit less smooth. And this version is made from dense plastic that runs very smoothly and I expect it will also do over time. With my double layer workbench, creating a clamping force between 60 and 70 kg is very easy. And although this is a lot, it works effortlessly to create this pressure. This clamping seems to go so smoothly and the clamp does not show any sign that it hurts the clamp in any way. It's just a very impressive hold down clamp. An advantage of the clamp from episode 29 is that there are three stages of setting and therefore it is possible to create a lower clamping force. And with this clamp it is more an all or nothing situation. Although you can lower the clamping force by clamping it with it just slightly touches your workpiece. However, the thickness of my workbench top can create more clamping power. On an 80 mm workbench top, the clamping force is between 40 and 50 kg, which is more than enough and will not harm the average project. The biggest difference is surprisingly. The black version costs around $10, which makes it a steal, and I like them very much. This version costs around $40 for a set of two, but you can see where the money went. From a quality perspective, it is without a doubt the better clamp. And because it's such a joy to work with, even for $40 for a set of two, I think it is a must-have tool in your shop. And this is my scoring card. And there's also another version of this clamp that works in a miter track. And it has the same build quality and it looks fantastic. The shaft is quite long, which gives it a good reach. However, it becomes too impractical for use on my drill press. But in my Mighty Trax, the fit is not perfect, and therefore it must bridge some space before the clamp has the grip to create force. And as a result, the clamping force is lower than that of the dog hole version. And because the clamp module can be slid up and down, it must be secured to the shaft before being clamped. And although you can turn the clamp mechanism in all directions, there is more play when you clamp something at the side of the T-track, which requires a little care to create a good clamping force. And besides that, the force on the T-track is not nicely spread, and in practice, I do not think this is the way to go. So I would leave it in the direction of the T-track. As a Mighty Trax clamp, it's definitely not as convenient as the dog hole version. However, I reviewed different Mighty Trax clamps in episode 26, and none of them works as conveniently as the dog hole clamp. So compared to these clamps, this one has a fantastic reach, although it falls short of the clamping force it can generate compared to those. And because of the construction with this screw and of course of the Mighty Trax bar, it costs a bit more than the dog hole version, which is more straightforward. Unfortunately, it is not as convenient to work with, and although I like the attempt to make a T-Track version of this clamp, I cannot say I enjoy working with it, and I guess you will have the same experience. So this is my scoring card. This is a short message that when you need some inspiration to make the best out of your workshop, visit my website www.hookedonwood.online. Here you'll find all the ideas I came up with to improve my workshop. And now I offer detailed plans for most of these ideas. So visit www.hookedonwood.online. And the last version is for a railguide. This one works with a Makita and a Vesso railguide. And of course, I think the quality is great, but I do not think these are ideal clamps for your railguide. A traditional railguide clamp works so much more conveniently, so although the quality is perfect, from a practical point of view, as with the former version, I do not think the design lends itself to any other than the dog hole version. Next product is this angle drill guide from EnjoyWood. And as I told you in the intro, they talk about an improved version. So I first wanted to find out the differences. And I got a former version a few weeks back, but I did not have the time to look at it before, so I have no idea yet. And the improved version finish look a bit smoother, but the biggest difference is the completely new design of the bridge that holds the chuck. And the packaging was perfect, and putting the drill guide together was very straightforward. And with just the first test, I noticed why they made an improved version. The improved version runs very smooth, which cannot be said about the former version. So I stopped the comparison here, because you can imagine the experience of working with them will be completely different. And the drill guide is pretty big, with a big platform allowing larger forstner bits to be used. And of course, you can use it also with smaller drill bits, but you must draw a pretty big cross when you want to align it. So let's first find out how accurate it is. And I tested the alignment, and the drill bit was perfectly centered, and I entered the workpiece right in the middle of the cross point. I think the used drill chuck is good for the product at this price point. There's just very little imbalance, but it does not harm the accuracy of your holes. When I place my drill bit in the hole, it fits very nicely and tight. And besides that, I made perfectly straight holes. The most interesting feature, however, is that you can change the angles. And when you use the angles, you can no longer use the center to align the drill bit. However, this applies to almost all these angle drill guides. It has some positive stops at every 15 degrees. So I tested the accuracy with the 15, 30 and 45 degrees. And at first, that 50 degree angle was slightly off, but the 30 and 45 degree stops were perfect. So I re-drilled the 50 degree angle, and now it is also perfect. So we can conclude the angles are set accurately. Another feature are these two V-shaped holders, and they make it possible to drill into a round workpiece. And this works very straightforward. It comes with two sets of extension rods with stops, making it easy to drill a hole to a particular distance from the edge. And the distance from the edge to the center of the drill bit is 70 millimeters. And when you need a closer point, you can place the stops under the drill guide's platform. Another feature are these two pins, which you can attach to the platform's underside. And these pins make it easy to find and drill a hole in the middle of a smaller workpiece or on an edge. Okay, let's see if you can make a straight angle hole. And here I use a 28 mm fastener bit. It's just a regular bit, and to make it as straight as possible, I clamp the base in place. And the round bar fitted perfectly, so I was very well able to drill a more giant hole straight and tight. And the angle was slightly off, but I think this is acceptable considering this is not a drill press and we use a pretty big fastener bit. This bridge has some screws that also secure the bearing. And I do not know why they choose this option, but it is important that you only tighten them slightly. So in the end, it's a very nice looking drill guide that is well packed. And based on its appearance, I found the price pretty attractive for what you get. It's a bigger drill guide, but I like that. It just makes it more stable and you can place it on your workbench with your drilling machine attached to it without falling. And I do not have many references for this kind of products, but it seems evident that it is not as stable as a drill press with such a mobile and lightweight design. So I think based on its design, they will all have some flex. So the more important question would be, are you able with some care and focus to drill nice, straight, angled and consistent holes with this drill guide? And I think that is very well possible. Its broader base makes it perfectly stable, and the fit and finish, to be honest, is very impressive at this price point. And this is my scoring card. Well, that was the end of this video. I hope you liked it. Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe, and well, we see each other next time.